Windows and Linux users have their life in terms of hardware compatibility much easier than Hackintosh or Apple Mac users. They can choose from variety supported products. So to get 10 gigabit Ethernet network card compatible with macOS Mojave or Catalina and working in Hackintosh was quite impossible task. Fortunately, you have me, Morgonaut, so stay tuned. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people with Apple computers, Hackintosh builds, Linux servers, simply overall with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. You know already, I always bring to you the best, easiest and fastest solutions. So today I have for you again one out-of-the-box working solution which is super easy and cheap. Let's go. The latest 2019 Apple Mac Pro has two 10 gigabit Ethernet ports driven by Aquantia chip. And I have found for you Hackintosh users 10 gigabit network card which uses the same Aquantia chip as the new Mac Pro and costs just $125. Isn't that amazing? Look at this. It's called Asus XG-C100C 10 gigabit network adapter. It's PCI Express by 4 and it's really small. It has massive heatsink which never gets hot and single 10 gigabit Ethernet port. Link where you can buy this exact card on regional Amazon stores you can find right now in this video description, so check it out. As you can see, this Hackintosh has only two 1 gigabit Ethernet ports on this Designare motherboard. But to add 10 gigabit networking has never been easier. I will shut it down and simply insert to the motherboard this little card. That's all. Just got one thing on my mind. Baby, one day I'm hoping that you will be mine. Turn my life around. Wow. So where? So, now let's check the network. Down to the beat, 10 gig Aquantia Ethernet. So, let's test if it's also working good. This insanely long orange cable goes to my Mac Pro over there. I will start iPerf network benchmarking tool in server mode. And on the Hackintosh, I will start it in client mode. Baby, one day I'm hoping that you will be mine. Turn my life around. Wow. Yeah. Where do we go when everything feels like it just stays the same? Where do we go from here when everything is said and done? Well, over 7 gigabits per second is much higher than just 1 gigabit. But it's still not 10 gigabit as it should. Can I improve it even more? Sure! On the Mac Pro, I have enabled Jumbo Frames or MTU 9000. So all I need to do is enable it also on this Hackintosh. Bang! Almost full 10 gigabit. Of course, the overall speed depends now not just on the network card itself, but also on speed of your disks. And most important is to use proper Ethernet cable. I personally use and I recommend to use Cat 7 Ethernet cable, which will give you 10 gigabit speeds for long distance. This cable is in fact 30 meters long, and look how great it performs. By the way, I have tested, just out of curiosity, to edit one of my 4K videos on my Mac Pro over 10 gigabit network directly from this Hackintosh. Overall performance, scrubbing in timeline, and final render times were absolutely the same as if I would edit it from one of my internal superfast NVMe disks inside of this Mac Pro. This brings whole new level opportunities, not just for Hackintosh users, but to Mac users too. Imagine, now you can easily build just separate file server for your video editing or storing massive amount of sound banks and samples. You can build or dedicate some old Hackintosh just for this task and save insane amount of money on it. So cheap, fast and reliable network card, which you can buy now on each regional Amazon store. Link to it you can find right now in this video description. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Don't forget to join my website morgonow.cloud so you will have always access to all of my videos, tutorials and posts or even to my individual 101 personal help. Morgonow is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.